EA Sports. It's in the game.
To me, it's all about Tom Brady. And he's just one of those guys that if the game's on the line, you need a big play, he'll make that play for you.
Second, reload! Second! 220!
Broke to pay attention, man.
Yeah.
Man, listen. All I got is this ambition.
That's it.
A couple million make you stand different.
Hey.
They dropped the ball and so I ran with it. I'm like, man, listen. All I got is this ambition.
You did.
A couple million make you stand different.
I am.
They dropped the ball and
Look,
so I ran with
the
it.
The game is friendless. The pain is endless. The game changed. I blame these lame pretenders. My friends and Benzes talked at the interest. Inside, you still hear the engine. Like, ren, ren, this is your ending. If you're offended, I dare you defend it. This is rushing through my blood like the Kremlin. I'm back with a vengeance. And this is what the sound of revenge is. Win, win. Man, listen. All I got is this ambition. A couple million make you stand different.
Hey.
They dropped the ball and so I ran with it.
I'm like, man, listen. All I got is this ambition. A couple million make you stand different. They dropped the ball and so I ran with it.
Where I come from, you can't visit. I talk money, I guess you understand different. Hand gestures count until my hands blister. You can't miss us louder than Fran Drescher. Pinky rings, hand kisses, soprano. I feel like Paulie Castellano when designer stitches. I heard him say I made Rihanna. Mind your business, what kind of honor is this? I'm trying to see Madonna, all kind of riches. In Miami, dining with the finest.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We've got a matchup today where the focus will be on the passing game. The Texans are top 10 at defending the pass, and they'll be going up against the Titans, who will need to solve that secondary. With that, let's welcome in our fine broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, they broke ground on this place in the year 2000, opened it in August of 2002, and it's been the home of this franchise ever since. Welcome to NRG Stadium in Houston. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Tennessee Titans and the Houston Texans. Hi again, everyone. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we look at this Texan ball club entering play here. They were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week is they put it together in every phase. Good offense, good defense, and some key plays on special teams. Let's see if they can get that second win in a row.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Titans, they've come in on a nice run of recent form, 4 wins out of 5.
And this coaching staff has to be pleased with how their defense played last week. They held their opponents to 3 points, and that was it. If they get anything comparable to that performance, this one's in the bag.
This is fielded at the goal line. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. So out come the Texans for their opening drive. And a glance at the tall signal caller, standing 6'6". As they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
Okay, there's a tone setter. First play from scrimmage, stuff them in the backfield.
You know what they were doing last night in the hotel room? Visualizing exactly that. That's what they were thinking about. Making that play, having leverage, lower than the offensive lineman, getting into the offensive backfield, knocking someone down. Just what you said, setting the tone early for this game.
Jeez, you are fired up.
When I see a play like that, I can't help it.
They'll run it again with Miller. And they see right through that defensively, as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. He'll wind up losing three, and now it's third down.
Okay, let's just make this one simple. We know that the running game is not their thing, but they can't just throw it on every single down without expecting some real heat from the pass rush.
And that's going to be too high, out of bounds and incomplete.
Trust me, Brandon, I'm not about to try and take your job. I can't do what you do, but that wasn't just three and out. That felt like three and backwards.
Well, that's exactly what it was. You can have my job whenever you want it. The drive that you're looking for, though, probably going forward, bad start to the ball game.
Yeah, not the way to get things going.
He punted five times in the win last week as this one's away. That's taken on the 25. Breaks through the contact. It's a 49-yard punt, but subtract nine there for the return. And it'll be Titan football. So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. And they'll be led out by their quarterback. Out of Oregon, it's Marcus Mariota.
I like this guy. And the reason I do, he tends to stand an even keel. Doesn't let too much ruffle him. He will manage the game the way it needs to be managed, take what the defense gives him, and then he can strike at times. Had a touchdown pass. Yes, he had an interception last week, but he found a way for his team to win.
To the flat, that's complete to his running back. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that. A little swing pass out to the right side, but for lost yardage.
Terrific read, better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for lost yardage.
And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle it, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that. Now that definitely hurts, because the mindset is getting a three and out there and they don't get it done. They give up the scramble and a pickup for a first down.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. They go play action here on first down. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Hart. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
And the play clock's running down. Mariota. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third. And the big boys up front in the trenches, what do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them, because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times, and they operate as a terrific unit.
Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass. Play fake, Mariota. They'll roll him out right. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. Mariota had an 87-yard run as a rookie. This one a bit less, but it is a first down.
On third down, the defense decided to blitz. A very good job of recognizing it, stepping away from the pressure, and finding open space to scramble and pick up a first down.
play fake here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Whitney Mercilus. From his outside linebacker spot, he comes up to drop him for a loss of 10.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. Our first update now comes from Atlanta, and an early advantage in that one for the Giants. Davis Webb leading the charge offensively. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. That run good for 6 yards, but they're still looking up at a 3rd and 15.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
3rd and long here for Mariota. Going for it all. He dropped it. Couldn't hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And the Titans hit the scoreboard first. It's 3-0. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive only yields 3 points.
Yeah, they were able to move the football, but the defense stiffened once their backs were to the end zone, and they were able to hold them to just 3.
Succop now set to kick it off following the made field goal. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Yeah, some might have returned that one. He won't. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start the drive from the 25. The Texans offense now, they get set to head back onto the field. And the last drive, the first drive for them, not very good. 3 and out. What do they go to here?
Well, you don't look down at your play sheet and say, this is what the problem is. Yeah, let's find out who my playmakers are. Get the ball in their hands, and maybe the offense will move a little bit better.
Sometimes it's more important to get it to the right people rather than dialing up the right number.
Exactly.
Or the right play, yeah.
That too.
And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. Again, it's Miller. Nowhere to go that time. Might have gotten a yard up to the 25. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
Now, prior to the snap, we hit all zeros as time has run out on the first quarter of play. 3-0 is our score. EA Sports NFL Sunday returns following this.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, and it's Texans football as we get going in quarter number 2. They've got it 3rd and 10 here to start things out.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue line.
He'll look to throw. And some space here. He'll have a first down past the 40, and he'll slide down to avoid the contact. A gain of 26 on the 3rd down conversion. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but it does get away and it's second down.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
Second down now after the incompletion. It's complete, and he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 16 yards on that one, and also a Texan first down. A first down carry now for Miller. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and four.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue 90.
On second down, here's Miller. And he'll get about four as he's brought down at the 24. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
Hurry up, here we go. 319.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And that is incomplete.
I have to say that was a surprise call on third and inches. I thought they'd try and run the football there, but you got to believe they thought they'd surprise the defense and pick up something downfield, but that one goes incomplete.
So now it's Andrew Franks on for the field goal. And this one, a 41-yard attempt. And Frank's kick is good. And that will tie us at 3-3. So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, but the net gain, 3 points.
And you're going to have drives like that in this league. Sometimes you just got to take the 3 and move on. Always better than nothing.
Here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. First down throw for Mariota. Going to throw right side here, complete. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
How about the timing on that one? Boy, they were in sync, weren't they? 3-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
Now a second down throw for Mariota. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. And hear the pressure from the outside linebacking spot.
And normally when that happens and they're able to get home, that means the other guys on his team helped him out a lot. That they occupied people to allow it to be no less than a one-on-one situation allows him to get home.
The Titans on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. And some room to roam now. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. He's able to chew up 8 yards on the carry there, but still fourth down upcoming. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. We're back to Houston after this timeout. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, we'll send you to Orlando and Larry Ridley, as he'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. But no touchdown. These guys need to give Larry some touchdowns to talk about.
Things are too easy for him right now back in the studio. Come on, guys, help the man out. Give him something to talk about.
They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. This one angles out of bounds at a good spot in the coffin corner. And they're going to mark this out of the 5-yard line. The Texans offense now, they get set to head back on the field here. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
Him down right around the 9, just shy of the 10. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll bring up a third down. The Texans on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6.
Hurry up, here we go.
They'll set up a throw, and he'll go out of bounds. Looks like right at the 15. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe-tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
Here we go now. 3-19.
Now a handoff to Miller. And a short gain across the 15 to the 17-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. Out of the pistol look, it's Miller, and he'll lose yardage here, back to the 15. So we are at halftime here on Halloween, as we send you over to our headquarters in Orlando, where we check in with Larry Ridley for our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Thanks, guys. We'll get back to you soon for the second half of this tied ball game. But first, let's look back now at this first half of play. Both the Texans and the Titans have very low rushing totals. It has not been an effective part of either team's game plan, and you wonder if either side will give a more concerted effort to run it in the second half. All right, let's get it going. Here's the first half highlights. Now to the middle of the first. Mariota's looking for room to run. He'll pick up more than 10 yards on the play. Titans, as though, would settle for just a field goal. Texans with it now early in the second. Run play coming up here. He'll end up running for over 20 yards on the play. Texans would later kick a field goal. That'll do it from here in Orlando. Let's get you back over to Houston as we rejoin Brandon and Charles.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This is fielded a couple yards deep. A beautiful fake. And now running right through it. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Titans offense now, they get ready to do battle again here. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Now they'll run it on the toss. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Now they'll run it on the toss. Room here to run. It's a foot race. 20, 10, touchdown Titans. A big play there with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Titans are able to strike for 6. They blitzed defensively there, but he was able to slip through that first layer, and then he was gone.
I think they won the leverage game, didn't they?
Yes.
Right? They saw the blitz coming. That got to him a little bit, but they leveraged it perfectly and found not just a crease, a gigantic hole. And off he goes, and he's still going all the way to the end zone.
And it is up. And it's good. That'll make our score 10-3 now. So two plays on that scoring drive. That's how they drew it up. And the long run into the end zone, and what a run it was. Now here's Suck about to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to get the
pressure comes, and the Titans able to bring him down. Jurrell Casey in there to get him, and that's sack number 6 for him on the year. And that'll be marked down as their first sack of the game.
Well, they had 6 last week. And this offense did its homework, didn't it? Because they saw all that pressure, and they really worked hard to tamp it down and beat it back. And they did a great job in the first half. But now they've gotten their first sack here in the second half. Look out. They'll try to increase the pressure.
Second down now after the sack. Here's a give to Miller. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll wind up going for a loss of 4. And they're going to be staring at a 3rd and long here.
Let's go!
Now back to throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
We're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. The Texans send the punter out as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Returnable here from the 38. A good return there, 17 yards. And the Titans are going to start this drive in great field position as they take over 1st and 10. Getting set to go again as we look at the back heading onto the field again. He's had a good performance, moved the ball effectively on the ground. Of course, he has the 1 touchdown.
And when you're able to move it as effectively as you've described, that leads to finding a way into the end zone. And now he's just trying to do it for a 2nd time. And, of course, with that, comes additional yardage.
Yeah, looking for additional yardage, and again that 2nd score here in the 3rd quarter. A 2nd time. How did he stay on his feet? Touchdown Titans. A
great effort there with his 14th touchdown of the year, second of the game. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead. Well, this offense.